beauty shots, birds, and we go like the wind.
Out of the engagement with the car, I would recommend the UUC short shift kit with the dual shear selector rod. The shorter throws, the more crisp gear changes, the directness, the reduction of sloppiness in the gear lever, it really adds the engagement to the car while driving. I've also done the performance clutch pedal upgrade, where you eliminate a little bit of the sideward movement of the clutch pedal. It just feels more straight to the point, more direct. And the clutch delay valve, I took that out of there. So the clutch delay valve delete, so you don't have the interference of the car, where it helps you to softly engage and disengage the gears. And that's more aimed towards people who have trouble stick shifting, dump the clutch accidentally. But if you know what you're doing, it's more of an interference. So most people take them out. I've done so as well. And those three together really add up to a more engaging gear shift experience. And with that, a better experience driving the car. So what I also had done to the car is the MILS upgrade. The modified intake lifter valve Tronic supports. They have a millimeter extra clearance in the supports, and they give an additional 8 to 10 horsepower across the rev range. It's a really easy upgrade to do. Check out Ultimate Beamer Experience, a fun new channel Craig Beamer also had that done, and he showed some footage.
Try this.
That upgrade works best with combined with a tune. I have not done any tune on the car yet. With all the other upgrades I've done, with the exhaust, with the mills, with the intake, with the exhaust manifold, a tune will really harmonize all those benefits and get the best out of that together. So I'm really hoping and shooting for 300 horsepower eventually. I don't know if I'm gonna make that, but I'm shooting for it anyway. But the main goal is to have a nice linear power curve across the rev range, and that's even more important than hitting a 300 horsepower somewhere. So I'm really looking forward to doing the tune. I will update you guys when that's done. Another thing I would like to have done and have not done yet is a limited slip diff. So there's a company here in the Netherlands called Hardeman. They supply OS Geeken limited slip differentials, and I'm really looking into that in getting that upgrade. It's pretty pricey, but the mechanical grip is undeniable, so I will be doing that, and that will also be on the channel, of course, in due time. So if you want to know more about the mills, check out Ultimate Beamer Experience, Craig Beamer. He made a video last week about it, showed some installation footage as well. It's a really fun channel, N52 focused, so I always watch his videos as well. And it's always good to see the N52 get represented on YouTube.